When you buy a form wash, they give you one of these to change the IPA in there. I ain't doing it.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Do you ever get home with all your things, but you have nowhere to set them? So it all just ends up in an ugly, disorganized, and hard to work with pile like this, causing you unneeded stress? Well, don't let it ruin your life. Get an Alfred backpack hanger today.
This video sponsor, PCBWay, offers 3D printing services. They offer FDM, SLM, DLP, SLA, and SLS. Materials include plastics and metals, such as aluminum, stainless, titanium, and tool steel. They also offer several post-processes for your part. Their lead time is pretty short. Check them out for your next project. Link in the description below. This is Nick Wilson. He created this IPA filtration system video on YouTube. Go check out his channel, link below. I'm basically copying what he's done, made a few modifications to filter my IPA. Thank you, Nick Wilson. To build one of these IPA filtration system, you'll need a chemical resistant diaphragm pump, a couple of filter housings. These are 10 inch ones. Readily available filters like these are cheap and easily accessible. I'm using a 1 micron and a 0.5 micron filter. Some clear vinyl tubing because it's cheap. A power strip so I can turn the whole system on and off. And some miscellaneous metal fittings, hose clamps to put it all together with. Maybe some UV lights so that we can harden up the resin in the IPA. There's a link to all the materials in the description below. In a previous video, I built this work cart station for my Form 3 for the form wash and the form cure and most of the materials that I use when I'm 3D printing with the Form 3. First, I'll attach the pump to the side of the cart. Next, we'll connect the two filter housings with a brass fitting to connect the two of them together. So the left one will have a 1 micron filter and the right one will have a 0.5 micron filter. Screw them together nice and good so it doesn't leak. And we'll mount this on the cart. Now I'll attach the two filter housings just for placement purposes to get a sense of how big this system is. I've got some brass barb fittings that I've put a little bit of plumber's tape on. And I'm putting them on the inlet and the outlet side of the filters. Next, there's a strainer that came with this diaphragm pump, and I'm gonna put this on here so if there's any big pieces in the IPA, they'll get caught in the strainer and not in the filter. I'll attach this power strip here so I can turn the whole thing on and off with one switch. Next, we'll attach the vinyl tubing here on the outlet of the pump, coil it up really nice, and connect that to the inlet of the first filter. And I'll connect those with some hose clamps so that I can screw them on, put some tie wraps around the vinyl tubing just to hold it all together. I 3D printed a little connector fitting that holds the vinyl tubing in place when it goes into the form wash. And the vinyl tubing just presses into these little raceways to hold the tubing in place. So this fitting clips onto the form wash and is held in place just by friction. Now let's connect the inlet to the pump. So vinyl tubing with a hose clamp and That is what's going to draw the IPA out of form wash, and the other side will be the return and put the clean IPA back into the form wash. I've got 33 feet of UV LED strips. So these are two 16 footers, 10 meters total, so 2 5-meter sections, and we'll wrap those around the vinyl tubing. So the idea here is when the IPA is going through this loop, it's exposed to the UV light and the uncured resin will harden and then get trapped inside the filters below that before it goes back into the form wash. Let me plug that into the strip and connect it, turn it on, works, easy. Let's install the two filters. This is a 1 micron filter here on the left, and the other one is a 0.5 micron filter here on the right. I need a way to deal with the ends of the hoses when they're not being used to filter the IPA. So I cut off some, I think this is a 1/2 inch conduit, and I'm gonna slip these rings onto the end of the vinyl tubing. And this is what I'm gonna use to help hold the vinyl tubing in place and keep it connected and not flopping around when I'm not using the system. I've 3D printed a very simple bracket on my bamboo carbon, and I'm gonna attach this to the work cart so I can hang the hoses up. Those rings just hold the vinyl tubing from slipping out. You could easily put a magnet in there as well if you wanted to do that. Let's start up the system and see how it works. So here you can see all the debris that's already in the IPA when it starts up. To show you how dirty it is, we'll snap on the little clip and then we'll just disconnect the hoses and insert them into the tank. So this is the return right here. And this is the inlet that draws the IPA in before it's filtered. Now, of course, the whole system requires a fair amount of IPA, probably 3/4 of a gallon to a gallon, something like that. So you're gonna need a little bit of IPA to fill these tanks and have in the system in addition to what you're already using for your cleaning system. The whole thing is pretty quiet, and I'm really pleased that it's not loud. Just add a little bit more IPA so that the system stays at the recommended level. Let me show you how clean the IPA is. You saw how quickly it got dirty before when I turned the little impeller on. It's pretty clean at this point, and I've run it every few jobs that I get, and this just keeps the IPA nice and clean. I never let it get really dirty, and just try to keep it as clean as I can all the time. I don't really have to do much except put the hoses in there every once in a while to filter the IPA, and I don't have to deal with it. I really like that.
I want to say thanks to Nick Wilson again, and there'll be a link to his channel in the description below. This is his system that I basically copied and made some modifications to. Additional modifications would probably be putting some aluminum foil tape here to contain some of the UV light leak. Other than that, I am tickled pink. I love how this thing turned out. And the IPA is quite clear. Certainly clear enough for what it is that I have to do. All right, so I know some of you are gonna say, it's too much money. Well, what's your time worth? For me, this is worth it. I don't have to mess with the IPA that's in my tank. I don't have to put it into a bucket, strain it, stick it in the sun, clean it, deal with all that goop spilling stuff, None of that. All I have to do is take these two hoses, stick them in the tank, run the system, and it cleans the IPA for me. Occasionally, I'm going to have to swap out these filters, and I should be able to do that because they have clear housings. Other than that, I shouldn't have to do anything. I'll leave a link in the description to the stuff that I used, so that if you want to build a system like this, that I highly recommend that you do. It's really, really much easier and will let you get to doing the things that you really want to do instead of cleaning your IPA. So for me, it's totally worth it.
If you click the link below to the Formlabs website and you purchase a machine, you'll get a $500 discount with my link below.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video.
Don't forget to follow me on social media at Bots and Design. I'm now on Blue Sky and unfortunately still on Instagram.
Rock on.
Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below.
Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.